Billy. You just sat down behind your drum set. It's 5 o'clock in the morning, which is, we all know you play that early.
Yes.
So you got your coffee going. What's one of the first things you're gonna do to your drum kit to make sure it's safe to play?
I generally check. Learned this the hard way again. Like what was just going wrong here, all the memory locks, make sure everything's locked in good, because when you start recording or even playing live, whatever, you don't want stuff moving around on you. This guy has, on this particular stand, has this nice feature here where you can, speaking of something different with the felt, just how much pressure you want between the felt, you can keep your wing nut tight on the top so it doesn't slip off, loosen this, and then this pivots and creates, you know, the amount of space or tension that those,
this is what, like a DW stand?
Yeah, this is a DW thing, and they also have these memory locks here, which are nice. You can crank these down. What had happened is I didn't put it very tight. When you get the angle, then you can tighten it down here. Welcome to Florida.
Yeah, it's storming outside.
So that's locked, so that if this gets bumped, that'll still stay in place. So it's sort of like just a double.
Very cool.
Lock that thing down. So yeah, this guy, you can tell we just set up. But especially if you're out, see, we're just setting here. What's going on with that guy?
Oh, you have to loosen up this part first.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Okay.
You get stuck underneath there.
Okay. Like I said, especially if you're torn, you definitely want to lock these guys in. It's going to nail the positioning, the angle, everything, the way it fits in there. So when you take this apart, throw it in the flight case, and take off, here's it to the next gig.
Yeah. Here's a tip for you: if you can't find some way to label your tom legs and your tom hardware, so you know which leg they came off of.
Yeah. What I used to do is just take a Sharpie, right on there, and then take a piece of just clear Scotch tape, put it on top of it, so fingers don't. You know, fingers or whatever gets brushed on doesn't erase it. Memory locks are really nice for that, obviously. If it's your home studio, obviously stuff won't get moved that much, so it's not that big a deal. I'm just changing.
But likewise, the memory lock also helps keep from, let's say this thing happened to shake loose, and your memory lock's way down here, your floor tom's going to fall.
Absolutely, yeah.
So, you know, if you got them, use them.
Got them, use them. Good point.
What's some of the other things you're going to take a look at?
I always check mic positioning. Make sure nothing got moved. You get used to seeing over time how they should be. Always double check all your mic positioning.
So what happens when you're in the middle of the song and you're rocking the hell out and you notice a mic that's out of the way? Do you actually try to fix it or you just keep going?
Take two. And do it again. Yeah.
You know, nothing like recording a track and get the end. You got one tom that just sounds like garbage.
Yeah. You know, you might dig in and accidentally bump it and you look down next to you know the mic is actually sitting on the head. Well, you know that's no good. That's trash. You're going to have to go back and redo that. What else? Just in general, keep an eye underneath here. Whether you're gigging live from time to time, I like to keep a check on these guys. Okay, now.
Hey, look at that.
We've got,
this is Billy Ashbaugh.
Look at that. That guy actually signed that thing. That's cool. Now, you've got the plastic strips, which are cool. If you're using the, the nylon strips, those can actually fray and break. But also, I've had strainers break in this area right here. The metal would just give over time. So just keep a check on them. Make sure everything's in place and everything's nice and solid. Because, you don't want this thing breaking in the middle of a track and all of a sudden you're smacking a tom.
Yeah.
I got to go back. Take three. So I'm checking the snares for that. And from time to time, I like to check pedal, moving parts. Make sure that no bearings are worn or anything of that nature. Just keep an eye on the moving parts. And it's more of a visual check, to be honest with you, when I sit down behind my kit. And it's the same, if you're out in the, gigging in a club or touring, same thing, when you're setting up or having the kit set up for you or setting it up, you kind of eyeball everything and you get a feel for it over time. I'm making lots of noise while I'm yakking, but you get the point. Make sure things aren't touching. You had mentioned that before. Make sure that, this, you can hear that. I'm going to move the snare out a little bit so the snare's not hitting the side of the tom, that sort of thing. Let's see what else.
So you said on your pedals, what exactly do you check, especially if you have double pedals?
Down here, I'll just check and make sure that everything's solid. What am I looking at? Here we go. Yeah, so that the beater and the shaft hasn't worked itself loose. Make sure that all the components here are nice and tight. This little wing nut down here, once you get the tension that you want to tighten this down, quite often this might slip loose. And then if that happens, you'll find that the threading is shifting and getting a little weaker on you as this thing goes down. So make sure those are locked in.
And what else we're looking at? Just, you know, overall maintenance from time to time, just to pull this thing out and, yeah, and check the sprockets and
I've
all the
had
springs.
These come loose on
those
my
you want to check, those little guys will pop out and you'll find them laying on the floor. I don't know if it really affects the feel that much, but then again, you know, you want to have them in there and just tighten down so that they're working for you. It's almost like they knew.
Yeah.
Same thing with the hi-hat. You know, you got moving parts over here. Quite often, you know, check these screws, make sure that they're nice and tight and still in there. This is a little toe stop here, but there's screws underneath it that hold the chain into it. I've had those come loose and break off in the middle of playing. That's no fun either.
I notice when you come in, you usually put your hands and feel the heads.
Looking.
You always seem like you're looking for a certain tension.
Not really, to be honest. It's probably just some weird thing I do.
Another Billyism?
That's a weird thing. Yeah. I mean, they're consistent. They're set in here, so. Nah, I don't.
Cool. Keith Thomas over here in the Gretsch. Beautiful Gretsch. What do you got to add to that, man?
I pretty much checked the same things, except also the tuning is like one of the biggest things I check when I, like any kit. It doesn't matter if it's my kit or anything out here in the drum freak house.
The drum freak house.
I come here and just, I pretty much do what he does. I tap on just to know that before I know we're all setting up and you're getting Logic set up, I'll sit there and just get an idea of what the pitches are. See if anything sounds off. I'll have to make a turn here or a turn there, you know. And then I'll grab a stick and start banging on them.
Cool.
Other than that, I'll just make sure everything's tight. If something feels like it's out of place, I'll.
This is the Dave Weckl replacement until we get a new one.
You know, in the studio setting, I don't do as much of a checklist as like live.
Yeah.
You know, but maybe it's because, you know, you can just go back and do it again. But live, yeah, I would go along and check
every single wing nut,
all the memory locks, because, you know, in the middle of the gig, it's the worst. Yeah. Everything. Oh, these guys, too, make sure that they're nice and tight. Next thing you know, you look down, it's flapping around on the head. That can't sound good out front.
When you're playing and the cymbal goes down, that's the worst.
Oh, yeah. So you want to check all those things.
Also, I use a Pearl, kind of like an Eliminator, I guess, or a T2000, 1000, whatever hi-hat stand. And this rod always comes loose down inside of there, right in here somewhere. And I constantly have to spin this thing. Even when I'm playing, you'll see me stop and try to put my hi-hat together.
What would work well to prevent that, which I actually do, is you buy the stuff you can buy at any like auto parts store. It's called Thread Locker.
Yeah, Thread Locker.
Oh, yeah,
You just put a little bit on it. It's like red or blue, whatever. It comes in a few different colors, but you put the red one is the one I use. I put it on, I turn it on, and then it'll dry, and it'll stay. But if you want to get it off, all you got to do is crank this down and just
break the thread.
Oh, so you can break
just
the seal.
Just snap it loose, and it'll come right off. It's not like JB Weld, or it's not going to weld it to the threads.
Don't use JB Weld. That's bad.
No, that's bad.